Alright, so if you don't know what we're doing for our second bicep movement, you clearly don't watch me enough, and that makes you a bit of a piece of shit. Alright lads, what's going on? Yes, I'm very aware that I look like a crackhead. No, I didn't just wake up, but doing a bit of study, so obviously there's no real reason for me to look presentable other than the fact that I've spontaneously decided to pick up the camera and show myself on the internet. But anyway, I was filming a YouTube video the other day, but you know, the microphone, because you like attach it to the clothes, when you move it kind of like jabs into your neck and gets all distorted and gross and everything like that. So I bought a mounted directional mic, which basically sits on top of the camera and then it picks up all the audio that, you know, the camera's facing at. So that should be pretty dope. I'm hoping that works well. I'm gonna be a little bit sus on how it works with the gym music and everything like that. But I think in essence, it'll be a lot better for like group kind of gym shit. So anyway, I told you I'm committed to bringing out a YouTube video every week. And you know, at this point, I don't give a fuck what goes wrong. I'm just gonna get one out, no matter what happens.
Oh my God! Wow!
You know what I mean? I'm getting my wisdom teeth out on Wednesday. I did film a whole fucking video on Saturday that just didn't come out well because, as I said, the microphone was all fucked up. So yes, I'm just fucking committing, lads. The wisdom teeth will probably put me out for, I reckon, half a week. The internet says 2 weeks, but I'm just built different, so I'm just gonna disregard their information.
Wait a minute! Who are you?
So what's on the agenda today? I gotta go look for a house inspection at 11, and then I got work at 2, so there's gonna be a time period of about 2-3 hours, so I'm just gonna get a gym session in. I thought, perfect time to pick up and film YouTube. I'll be filming a TikTok mic'd up session, and then I'll mic this entire session up as well.
Okay.
As I said, I'm just getting a lot of fucking content out in this first half of the week, so that way, you know, when I'm, you know, off and can't do anything in the last half, at least somewhat will be made up for, but yeah, let's get into it. Alright lads, here at the UFC gym, about to go hit an absolutely filthy pull session. It's gonna be upper back focused and I reckon long head of the bi. I'm sort of just, you know, doing what I feel these days, like I'm just throwing in different days of my different programs, mainly so I can record them and, you know, obviously get content out for you lads, but also just because they're all like, you know, fun to do and I just enjoy mixing them up. So it is Monday, I never really hit fucking back on Monday, ever, so good to change things up every now and then. So if you didn't know, I've got a hip injury, but I reckon we're almost getting to the point where I can start hitting legs again light. Super keen. I've never been one to actually really enjoy training legs, but I've always been like, you know, if I don't train them, I'm just a pure bitch. So fucking keen to be able to get back in there. I reckon I'm just gonna abuse those little fuckers like they owe me money when I can. Yeah, so just a little life update for you lads. Very keen to fucking start growing some big fuck off juicy wheels, but let's get into this back workout, eh? Alright lads, to start off our session, we're going with some heavy machine rows, alright? We're going to aim for an 8 rep range as this is going to be our heaviest movement. Make sure you're getting a full range of motion, holding the squeeze and controlling the weight at all times, alright? Now if you're from TikTok, welcome, you better sub. I was going to say I would eat your ass if you don't, but you'd probably like that, you freak.
What?
Alright, this is my second heavy set. Pretty much just maxing out the fucking machine. That's what we do around here though. Woo! Big dogs gotta eat.
Yep.
Shit. Ooh. My back's already feeling fucking juicy as. It's only the first movement. This is gonna be an absolutely sickening workout. Oh, one more. One more. Oh, fucking really shit myself. Holy fuck, I'm nearly about to pass out. Oh. Fuck. This is what weight we're working with, by the way. 4.5 plates on each side. Sometimes you've just got to disrespect, you know, and give it a little slap. Really make sure the weight knows who's boss, you know what I'm saying?
Alright, for our second movement, we're going to move it into a conventional lat pull-down. Now, despite its name, no, it actually does not work the lats too well, but what it does do is it works the teres muscles, which sit right above the lat just in there. Even though it doesn't contribute to the actual lats itself, it does contribute to getting a big fuck-off and wide back. It's also one of the most aesthetic movements you could possibly do, in my opinion, which, I'm not going to lie, is a large reason I like doing them. They also feel fucking orgasmic and provide an absolutely disgusting pump. Going for about 10 to 12 reps here. Control the movement, make sure you're getting a nice stretch, holding the contraction, and just fucking repeat, lads. Pretty simple process.
Oh, that felt fucking great. How are we looking?
All right, so on to our third back movement. We're gonna go with a parallel grip low row. You'll notice I do horizontal movements, then I do vertical, horizontal, vertical. And the reason for that is it just provides an absolutely sickening pump. I like to switch things up, keeps things interesting, and that's just the way I fucking do it, so suck shit.
Oh, okay.
Usually I do go with a parallel grip low row with the handle, like with the bar. Today I'm gonna try out the D handles just because, you know, I've never really done it before. I'm gonna see if the traction's a little bit better, and it's always good to try new things, so let's fucking do that. Now, the parallel grip low row is something that I've only relatively recently started incorporating into my training. But if you don't do them, oh, that's uneven. But if you don't do them, I highly recommend throwing them into your program because they are absolutely fucking filthy. Now the important thing here is just controlling the weight, not using too much momentum, making sure your back doesn't go past that neutral grip, you know what I mean? Or that neutral position, sorry. All right, so I'm looking over my shoulder all seductively and shit. So I do think that the D handles provide a little bit better contraction than say the bar. But in saying that, I was sort of losing my grip positioning and I was sort of rotating downwards, which made it a bit awkward at the end. So I do recommend trying. I'm just gonna keep adding them in and, you know, obviously get better with them over time. But yeah, they're pretty fucking mint. How's the back aesthetics looking? Oh, ooh, ooh, that better be looking filthy. So I swear I keep saying this, but this is one of my favorite movements, all right? It's the inclined chest supported dumbbell row. Provides an absolutely filthy pump. I like doing it to finish off the session. And the pump, as I said, is just absolutely disgusting. Nearly crushed my thumb there. You can go decently heavy on these, but again, it's just all about controlling that movement, feeling the contraction, and you know, chasing that fucking pump. It takes a bit of skill to get into this position, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
Woo. From the first rep, it is just utterly orgasmic. Going for about 12 to 15 reps. Oh, oh, fuck. Woo. Oh, orgasmic, lads. All right, lads, onto a bit of curls for the girls. We're gonna go with an easy bar, preacher curl. We're gonna go with a bit of a close grip to work the long head of the bicep a little bit more. Usually I would prefer a pin-loaded preacher curl, but we're just working with what we got today. So have a little bit wider elbows, closer wrists, and then just control the movement. Make sure, anytime you're doing biceps, make sure you're doing full range of motion. Otherwise you can develop tendonitis, and that's why those fucking huge bodybuilders walk around with their arms all curled up and shit, looking like they're fucking, you know, trying to look like they're big. It's because their fucking tendons just shortened up over all the heavy lifting they're fucking doing. Full range of motion, 8 to 10 reps. Really low, this is that heavy arm movement, all right? So really load it, get inside the fucking muscle. Oh, fuck. Fuck me, I was close to a bicep tennis.
All right, so if you don't know what we're doing for our second bicep movement, you clearly don't watch me enough, and that makes you a bit of a piece of shit.
We're moving into a rope hammer curl. Basically, that just builds the brachii, which is essentially just a muscle that lays deep to the bicep heads, and that really pushes it out. So from that front view, it gives it a wider look. Instead of like, you can have really thick fuck off biceps, shit, but if you don't have a nice developed brachii, then from the front, you're just gonna look like a scrawny little bitch. I always like drop setting this one, so that's exactly what we're gonna fucking do. I like to have a little bit of a elbow flare. Just helps me feel the mind-muscle connection in the brachii a little bit better. Really important to slow the tempo down on this. Hold the squeeze, slow eccentric, and then you can explode out of that concentric. Aiming for about 10 to 12 reps on the first one. We drop the weight, and this is where we speed up the tempo, right? Start repping them out, blow those fucking biceps up. This is the perfect workout if you're about to go on a date with a fit MILF. Need to be filling out those t-shirts. No, it's not going anywhere.
Alright lads, to finish off biceps, we're going to be working our long head in the lengthened position with an incline dumbbell curl. Only recently started doing these, but these are pretty fucking filthy, so I do recommend trying them out. I would love to do face-away cable curls, but they just don't have narrow like cable machines here. So these will have to do, but they're still fucking filthy. And it's good just to switch up a bit of dumbbell work. So we've done a bit of easy bar, a bit of cable, and now a bit of dumbbell. Very nice well-rounded workout in my opinion. 12 to 15 rep range, so we're going pretty light. As always, control the movement. Good range of motion. Fuck, that stings, man. Shit. Fight through the pain, my lads. Feel the burn. Love the burn. Fuck, nah, it's not going anywhere. Woo.
Yeah. They were sleeping, they were snoozing me. I was dreaming but with food to eat. Why was seizing opportunity? Now they don't know what to do with me. I keep going hard like I'm in puberty. Rebellions in my blood, there ain't no ruling me. I'm coming for the top, this is a mutiny.
Alright lads, I'm gonna wrap it up here. Gotta go to work now, unfortunately. It's not that bad actually, I quite enjoy my work. But anyway, so I'm investing quite a bit of money into getting these vlogs better, you know what I mean? Those day in the lives. I'm gonna, as I said, get that directional mounted mic, and that will really be good for like group setting stuff, so it's just not me talking shit the entire time. You know, I've had a few different issues creating YouTube videos over the last couple of weeks. You know, sometimes, you know, I just have to stop recording for external reasons. The other time when I recorded just the other day, the mic wasn't on. Or the mic was on, sorry, but it was like jabbing into my neck, so the audio didn't come out very well. But I'm just, you know, I'm doing whatever it takes to get these YouTube videos out right now. I think The Rock said it best when he said, it's about drive, it's about power. Those words really moved me, and, you know, I just carry them in my heart every single day. So, if you did like this video, make sure you drop a like, drop a sub, and I'll see you in the next one.